Editing with the DaVinci Resolve Color Manage workflow is incredible, but there's a problem with it. As soon as you add any title or graphic from the Fusion page, colors end up dull and desaturated, white becomes gray. It's not just bad, it's wrong. The issue happens with the built-in Text Plus title graphic, as well as all the fantastic new Fusion titles from Motion VFX that I started to use lately. However, I found the fix, so therefore, today, I'm going to show you how to continue using a color managed workflow and have color accurate Fusion graphics using a new feature in DaVinci Resolve 17 called Render in Place. Render in Place helps you get real-time playback in your timeline with any clips that have intense effects. After you right-click and choose to render in place, Resolve swaps the original clip with the rendered file. And two ways that this method beats the good old render cache are, one, you can actually trim and move clips without needing to recache them, so no more red bars at the top of your timeline. And two, you can use it in any other project or timeline because it's just a new video clip. Render in place files still have the flexibility to revert to the original clip to make changes using Decompose to Original, and you can pick your storage location and media pool bins for each iteration of the graphic. Just select the bin you want it to end up in before performing render in place. Now, Resolve also keeps every version that you render, which is great when clients decide they'd rather use that version you sent over 2 weeks ago. Not saying any names here, but this might have just happened to me on a recent project. And if you're unsure about working with the DaVinci YRGB Color Manage workflow, I've got an easy to follow tutorial linked on screen, and it's perfect for beginners to pros. You can see my project is using the DaVinci Wide Gamut, which normalizes my Blackmagic RAW clips so they look nice automatically without using a LUT. But if I drag a Fusion title like Text Plus above a clip, the white title becomes gray. You might think the solution is to right-click and bypass color management for the Fusion title, but unfortunately, that doesn't work. Maybe that's how it's going to work in version 18, but here's how to currently fix the problem. Open your project settings in the lower right corner or use the keyboard shortcut Shift-9. Go to Color Management and change the color signs from DaVinci YRGB Color Manage back to the default of DaVinci YRGB and hit Option on a Mac, Alt on a PC, and Save. Using Option is a little tip that lets you keep your project settings open and make more changes. Also, make sure you set your timeline resolution to whatever your final output needs are. For instance, if you're editing at 1920 by 1080 for better editing performance, which is a good idea, but you want to deliver in 4K, change this to 3840 by 2160 now and save this new setting. The render is going to end up being the size of your current timeline settings. Rendering in place is simple. First, select the bin you want your clips to end up. Right-click, choose Render in Place. I like to choose Format Set to QuickTime, Codec Type Set to ProRes, and the flavor will be ProRes 4444, which has transparency included. That's the alpha channel, the clear see-through channel. If you're on a Windows machine, I would choose a 4444 DNxHR codec instead. Now, select Render and choose an organized folder location to save the file. You can even select and render multiple clips at once if you need to. Then revert to your original project settings with Shift-9 to change your timeline back to 1920 by 1080 for easy editing, and set the color management back to DaVinci YRGB Color Manage with the DaVinci Wide Gamut preset. That's my favorite, and save it. Client notes? No problem. It's easy to make changes. Just right-click and choose Decompose to Original, open the inspector in the upper right, and here you can customize this Fusion graphic from Motion VFX with a new photo using drop zones, or you can easily change the font size using this excellent bonus precision tip I've got for you. Click the field you want to change, and then with your keyboard, you're going to use the left and right arrows to navigate the different digits, and then the up and down ones are going to make small incremental changes with each key press. This keyboard arrow tip works across all of Resolve and is really handy. Then open up your project settings again and change the project back out of YRGB Color Manage. Adjust your timeline resolution if needed, and you're good to go. Hey, if you're new here, welcome. I'm Chadwick. This is Creative Video Tips. It's all about helping you craft stories that make a difference and stand out. Subscribe right now if you're into that so you don't miss out on the next great tip. Thanks to Motion VFX for taking me on as an affiliate, and one way you can now support the channel is to use links in the description for Motion VFX plugins. They make some of the best customizable titles out there for Final Cut Pro, and now we're expanding into support for DaVinci Resolve, which we all love. You can also start any Amazon shopping spree if you want through a link in the description. Thanks to Alex Cameron, who taught me this trick on his excellent YouTube channel. And hey, if you want to learn more about using DaVinci Resolve, click on the playlist. It's on screen right now. And because there's so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video.